Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Nordic Turns. Alan is from Halmstad, Sweden. Maybe you are surprised to look like this face is like purple, red or purplish, something like that. Yeah, because I already finished 3.5 miles running, but the resolution is 7 kilometers by less than 1 hour. So I'm preparing for the next session, 10 kilometer running competition, that is for the blood donor or some other activities, like voluntary activities. So I'm preparing for that. So resolution is 7 kilometer, 3.5 kilometer has been finished, and I'm resting now. So I feel that some important things I can discuss with you. I kind of resist myself speaking English because last week there are like more than 100 emails and SMS from India and some other African countries. They want to come here, but they don't have sufficient information, and then they want me to make the video in English. So I cannot keep myself restless to speak in English. So this video I'm making in English. Some important information will be given by this video. First of all, I want to congratulate all of the students, those who are selected for the Swedish University Master's program this year 2019, and who are applying for the visa. Congratulations, all of them who already applied for the visa and got the visa, and preparing to come here in Sweden. And then I would like to thank everyone who is like the button of Nordic Turns, subscribe the channels, and like the videos that I share all the time for you. Secondly, I should congratulate the other students who applied for the visa but didn't get any reply. How it works, I will describe very shortly. First of all, I want to inform you that the visa process, application process, and then the visa acceptance process is kind of 2 to 3 months minimum waiting time. If you go to Migration Worket and then or Migration Agency, Swedish Migration Agency, you will see that there they have the timeline that you apply electronically, and then you apply, you send all the documents, and there is nothing requirement from the embassy yet, and then what is the waiting time. So it's nearly 2 to 3 months at least. But some people, I will give a pause because the bus is running, so it's very noisy here. So I will pause like 1 minute maybe. So welcome back. How are you all living in Bangladesh? All of my followers, Facebook followers, Instagram followers, and then YouTube followers, everyone, thanks again for all of you, to all of you that you make me someone who give the information voluntarily, and now he has taken the decision to open a web page. So I'm working on the web page, www.nordicturns.se, and I would like to request you that keep watching on the web page, because the web page, I blocked it for all of the customers and all of the followers, because it's kind of disturbing sometimes when I'm working with the programming and some other things to follow them and to reply them. So I blocked it. When it will be launched, then I will start everything in details to give the information and some other things. Okay, so now what we are talking about? We are talking about migration worker. So it's the waiting time is 2 to 3 months. So some people is asking me by SMS that I applied on 16th of May, and this is like 40 days already. I didn't get a reply because it's the process, and this process is not done by the automatical things. It's the manual process. So they will check everything, and then they will give this to the Swedish Migration Worket, and then Swedish Migration Worket will check it, and then they will entry the data and everything in the system, and then they will play something with you, like interview or without interview, visa or something. So it takes time always. I would like to request all of you to have a patience on this, because all of them I found very impatient. They are like applying now, and in 20 days they need to get the visa. How? It's not possible. Yeah, I understand. When some people are like not getting respond or something, they are applying like very early, but later who are applying, they got the interview call or something. Maybe you were selected without interview for the visa, so you don't know anything about that. So maybe it can change in a different way. So case to case is different. Don't compare with others, those who are applying. Everyone's situation is different. They showed their money in a different way. They applied by themselves, in a third party, in by themselves or by other selves. So case to case is different. Don't compare with others. That's my first suggestion. And then those who are telling me, Alan bhai, I applied for like 16th of May or 10th of May, and then I am calling for the interview in 29th of August, and 3rd of September the class will be started and the mandatory registration will be processing. So how I will catch the classes and how I will register in the university if I cannot get the visa. And last year also it happened, but this time they are working in a very good way. So they recruited some people to have extra work and workload, and then the system will be go in a sound way. So I will suggest you just keep patience and give your update to the university time to time. Your update is very important. When you are updating with all the information that you have from the migrations worker, that is very important, because then you can say something when you will be here in the university, and university cannot say anything because this is the visa processing. No one has the hand of it. So I will think that it will help. So have this kind of things by email time to time to university, and have the communication with the university administration. That's my request. Okay, those who are preparing for already for the flights and other things, book the flights. If you have kids, you cannot do that. But if you without kids, without children, then you can book the flight from what it's called studentuniverse.co.uk. This is very important because the price is very minimum here for the student. So you can book for you and for your husband or wife in a very good way and very cheap price. So studentuniverse.co.uk, you can book the flight directly from there, and this is very cheap, I swear. So you can use that to book the flight. And then after flight, what you should bring, what you should not, that I will discuss in another video. Now time is not giving me that chance to describe everything here, but I will make a video for the preparation after July maybe, because then people will start getting visa, and then it's nice to talk about what should be, what should bring or what should not, and what should be the preparation or something. For the resigning from the company that you are working for, don't resign before confirming anything, so that if the visa is rejected and you will lose your job as well. So don't do that. So when you are confirmed, that you give the biometric and then you got the dossier number with the confirmation mail that your decision has been made and it's accepted, then you can resign from the current company that you are working for. Otherwise it will not be wise to resign from the company that you are working for. I would like to request you that to make a more easy and convenient way discussing with your boss if he's friendly. Otherwise, if he's not very much friendly, then make him out that you don't know anything, he doesn't know anything, nobody knows anything. And then after getting the visa, just click. Okay. And then for the doctors, some doctors are coming this year as well, and I was preparing to make a video like 6 months ago, to make a video about the doctors who are coming here, or what is the purpose, what is the reflections, what is the job opportunity, what is the city hospitals here, about everything for the doctors. But I couldn't make the time for that, so maybe I will make the video in August for the doctors, for all the doctors. I have some preparation for that, but I think I need more preparation for that. I have some friends like I doctors and surgery, head of surgery in Halmstad hospitals. So I would like to talk more about the professions and how they get the job, and when they are from different countries, what is the requirement for getting the job, for the practicing for a physician or something, that I need to discuss. But otherwise I have the knowledge for that what is the laws and what should you do when you are you will be in here as a doctor. So I will discuss this more in my other videos. It will be specially segregated for the doctors, I think. Okay. And last but not least, that the question that arises from the HSC past student, like for the bachelor, the webpage is designing for Germany, because it's free education. So Germany, who interested for to do the bachelor in Germany, they can directly order their package from www.nordicturns.se, and then I will start working with this. For timing, I will not directly reply all the message, because I hired some lawyers and some other experienced people to work with me. So some students also who has the time, and I will pay for this to them. So I will organizing this in a right way so that people have the trust, those who are like paying in advance, and then they are getting the service as they are paying for that. So I think that will be easy for the bachelor degree students who want to do their bachelor in some subjects. Sweden is not good for bachelor students to do the bachelor degree here, so it's paid, so it's not good at all for the bachelor degree program students. So I would like to recommend you to do bachelor in Germany, because that's for free. So you will have some regulations and some other things after doing your bachelor, then you come to Sweden directly with the master's program, and it will be easier for you, I think. So that's my suggestion. I think always I like to give you the right information and the convenient information for my Bangladesh people, students. Those who are in Middle East want to come here, from Malaysia, from Australia, from some Australian as well. They want to come to here because there are some problems with the pier there now. So they're rejecting the pier, and then they want to come here. Some African people, those who want to come here, I would like to request you to contact with me through www.nordicturns.se. Okay, so that's all for today, and I would like to request you for everything that you do, always to take the preparation before coming here. That will be the continuous process. So stay tuned with Alan from Halmstad, Sweden, with Nordic Turns and nordicturns.se. Thank you very much for watching me. Assalamu alaikum. Allah Hafiz.